Yes, thank you. I'm Olav Torp from Norwegian University of Science and Technology. I'm going to present a work that I have done together with two Norwegian contractor companies, Veidekke and AF Gruppen. We discussed about integration of uncertainty management from project management, traditional project management, and last planner system. I have the co-authors, some of them are here, so we decided that I do the presentation and Lars Petter will answer the difficult questions, okay? Let's try. Yeah. The structure of the presentation, I'll first give some background about the discussion we had from the start. Then I say some words about the research methodology. I will present the findings and give some conclusion about our work. Then I start with the background. And much of the background lies in this picture that we have the last planner system. I guess all of you already know the last planner system. It's about, we heard earlier today, it's about constraints, removing constraints, and it's also about risks. But from traditional project management, we have saying that the uncertainty management is an important issue to handle uncertainties. And uncertainty management processes are described. It's about risk management or uncertainty management planning. It's about doing uncertainty analysis. It's about handling risks, handling uncertainties. And it's about a continuous process in the project to handle uncertainties. The two contractor companies, Veidekke, for many years have worked with last planner system, implemented last planner system in their organization. While AF Gruppen, for many years, have worked with uncertainty management. But Veidekke have now started thinking about how they can implement uncertainty management, and AF Gruppen the last these years have tried to work with how to implement last planner system. So they are in a kind of different, these two contractors, and different levels of this. Let's see. The background then, the objectives we discussed is to look into if project planning and control could be improved by implementation, integration of last planner system and uncertainty management. And if yes, how could we do this integration? The research methodology we used was first to do a literature review of what we could find about uncertainty management, and what we can find, of course, about last planner system, but also what we can find about already written about integration of these two. So we looked for that. And in addition, we had a series of workshops with representatives from the industry and from the university to discuss about the integration, what we achieve and how we can do it. So we had, I think it was five workshops where we discussed different models, different ways of doing this, different ways of integrating this, these two concepts. I will not say more about these research methods. Findings, is it a good idea? We could already find something written about this. Both last planner system and uncertainty management, it is about reducing variability. What we can see is that last planner system focused on schedule uncertainties or removing constraints in the schedule. Uncertainty management also discusses about different kind of consequences, like consequences for cost, consequences for safety, consequences for company reputation, etc. So different kind of consequences also about schedule, but also different. Last planner system focus on prediction of for sound activities, the 7 preconditions, and uncertainty management focus on identifying the most important uncertainties, prioritized through uncertainty analysis. And based on that, we can define an uncertainty register, and you could have a top 10 like focus list of the top uncertainties. Last planner system focused on reducing waste, and hereby reducing variability, while also uncertainty management also discuss about how to exploit opportunities and positive uncertainties that occur in the project. And also we can see that uncertainty management covers, in addition to variability, also about this single event uncertainties, how to handle the events during the project. We found some earlier work discussing this issue. We found Ballard and Vaughan from IGLC 27 discussing framework for managing variation in a project, where both the statistical described variation and single event are handled. We found Hamsi and Weber propose a framework for integrating failure mode and effect analysis in addition to constraint removal in the look ahead planning. So we can find some issues. Clark et al. Discuss this on another level, how to integrate these two. So we concluded that, okay, it could be a good idea to do it, and then we discussed how can we do it. And the basis for integration we found to be the meeting and plan structure of the last planner system. So we could try to integrate uncertainty management in the meeting structure and the plan structure of the last planner system. The master schedule, it will offer input to the last planner system, of course, and prior to that, or in relation to the master schedule, we'll do an overall uncertainty, the first uncertainty analysis in a project, and that could offer input to the master plan. And will also be the first version of the uncertainty register for the project. We found also that maybe some uncertainties could be handled by the last planning system, and some could be handled outside the last planning system. So we also need to identify what kind of uncertainty could be handled by last planner and what could be handled outside the last planning system. We found that in lean terms, opportunity in risk in uncertainty management, you talk about risk management and opportunity management. In lean terms, we found that risk opportunity management is about it could be waste reduction or increasing of the value. We found that prior to the phase schedule meeting, look ahead meeting, and the weekly work schedule meeting, the coordinator or owner of the meeting should prepare for the meeting and prepare a kind of uncertainty top list or focus list from the above level. The owner of the meeting also needs to set the agenda for the meeting at this level. We developed two figures. The first one is about the plan level. And they say that some uncertainties come from a higher level, from the master schedule. We identify some uncertainties, but they need to be handled at the lower level, at the operational level, for instance. So it's a kind of top-down process. Some uncertainties could be handled at the level they are identified, and some uncertainties are identified at the lower level, but need to be handled at the higher level. So it's a kind of mix of top-down process, bottom-up process, and handling at a certain level they are identified. The other picture is about the system we propose, that you have a uncertainty focus list from master plan level. You do the master plan meeting, and you end up with the master plan that is input to the phase schedule. So you have a kind of uncertainty top list or focus list as input to the phase schedule meeting. Have the meeting and as input the phase schedule. As input to the look ahead meeting, you have a uncertainty focus list from the above level. But what we see is that the uncertainties need to be translated or focused or concretized, because on the top level you could have an uncertainty like, okay, it's uncertainty related to the subcontractors. But on the down level, at the phase schedule or look ahead schedule level, you need to concretize that to, okay, what is this kind of uncertainty? How could this uncertainty be handled at this level? Then, from the look ahead, you have this input, you have this uncertainty top 10 list or top list or focus list. And you have a meeting to discuss the uncertainty, and you have the output is the weekly work plan. So this is the system that focus list is different on the top level. There you might have the top 10 uncertainties, while on the, for instance, the look ahead schedule at that level, you could have the top 5 uncertainties at that level. And these are more concrete, more different, kind of different than the top uncertainties. So conclusions, we found that the companies involved, they find this promising and they will try this out, they will test this in real projects. So we try to identify one project in Veidekke, one project in AF Gruppen, and try to test this system. However, there are some concerns, and that is that there could be a risk that loading more in even more tasks into a last planning system could result in a failure or could not be positive. And which specific questions concerning uncertainties should be asked at the different plan levels? And how should the answers be documented, communicated, and followed up? Will this translation of the focuses to the different plan levels function in practice? We don't know. We have some ideas how to do it, but we have no evidence of it. And is last planning system equally suitable for managing different kinds of uncertainties, like not only schedule uncertainties, but also uncertainties related to cost, reputation, etc. That was my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That's almost perfect timing. You could have had another 20 seconds. So we'll take questions at the end. Our next speaker is Iris Tomalang, who's going to tell us about the receding edge and how to manage it.